Hello everyone. So this is the last session during the fourth module. So now we will be talking about what is service design and design thinking. So we can ask a very philosophical question. So what is a good service, or what is the goal of the public sector overall? So we could say that the public sector needs, or its goal is to provide the public with good services. But at the same time, we should ask, what is really a good service? Or how do we define something like a good service or a very excellent service? A good service really means different things to different people. So for one person, it can mean that the service is really easily usable, or it can be found really quickly on the internet, for example. But for others, for example, it can also mean that the service is automated. It can really mean anything to anybody. And there is the question of how do we really make sense of how organizations are seeing the services and how the public is seeing the services. And here's the question, how do we actually design the services that would make sense for both parties, or actually to all stakeholders in the public sector? And for that, we can claim, for example, that the public sector and the organizations in the public sector should focus on what people need. And how do we actually find out what people need? We ask, we use different techniques to find out how people react to what is provided out there. So there are different techniques for that. So we can use storyboard technique, for example, or five questions or five whys. We ask if there are some personas that we could imitate, or maybe there are ethnographies that we could use. So there are actually many, many different ways how we could ask that question. What do people actually need? But there are some characteristics or some ideas that should be very often kept in mind. So the services should be easily used. They should be clearly understandable, so people actually know what is needed to be done, how can they access the service. Also, there have to be availabilities for the specialists or the people who actually are working behind the scene. So services should also create positive emotions, so people want to come back to the organization and use the services in a way that they're intended to be used. And of course, there should be standardized solutions. For example, using different websites. There are so many different services on them, but they should be presented in a clear manner, so we would actually know what is expected. Unfortunately, we can never take everyone's opinions into mind. So for that reason, we should really exclude the more extreme opinions and focus on serving the needs of as many people as possible. So thank you for listening. I'm Regina Sirendi, and hopefully you will find more useful information from the module. Thank you.